Hello, Céline. In Belgium and most European countries, the economy is recovering from the COVID-19 pandemic. The vaccination campaigns are on track and the number of deaths and contaminations is still decreasing. The question is, of course, is this same positive evolution happening all over the world? And I think that's a good question for you, Céline Boulenger, macroeconomist at De Groof Peterkamp. What do you see happening in the world?
So what we see is, in our developed countries, we see that cases are falling, we see vaccination campaigns that are picking up pace, and these are good news, right? It's making us quite optimistic about the future. We can almost touch a back to normal kind of situation. But we can't forget that as long as COVID-19 is spreading in other parts of the world, we won't be protected from it, right? We're still vulnerable to new waves of COVID-19 at home.
Do we see big differences across countries in terms of containing the virus and vaccination?
Yes, so we see that if vaccination campaigns are picking up pace here, it's not at all the case in the poorest countries. So we see vaccination campaigns are quite slow. To give you an example, for example, in the US, I think at least 50% of the population is vaccinated. And then in India, it's around like 3%. In Africa, it's only 1%. So huge differences in terms of vaccination. And this is partly because at the very beginning, developed nations hoarded vaccines. So they ordered more doses than they needed for their populations and left very little for emerging markets. This is quite dangerous, of course.
Is this just bad news for developing countries, or is there also a risk for the developed world?
This is, of course, bad news for emerging markets. This vaccine nationalism that was done by developed markets, it's dangerous for everybody. Because for emerging markets, that makes them more vulnerable to COVID-19, but also the economic impacts of it. But then for us, we can't forget that we live in a world that is highly interconnected. So if emerging markets are struggling, that means that I can have impact on global trade because it can lead to disruptions to global supply chains. It can also impact global financial markets.
And I imagine there's also a health risk for the developed world.
Of course, we know that the longer we wait to vaccinate people in the poorest countries, the more likely it is that new variants are going to appear. Those variants could be more dangerous, but they could also resist to existing vaccines. So it's quite dangerous for us to wait too long to vaccinate people in other countries.
And so the question is, what can be done to address this situation?
First, we need to talk about it. I think it's a topic that's not talked about enough. And then, of course, developed countries need to help emerging markets, to help the poorest countries gain access to free vaccines. Right now, the poorest countries, they rely on the COVAX mechanism. It is a mechanism that has pledged to vaccinate the populations of 92 middle and low income countries. But right now, their mission has been compromised. This is partly because their largest supplier, the Serum Institute of India, has halted the supply of their vaccines. This is because India has been struggling with a bad second wave. So their mission is compromised. They've made new deals, but it's going to take a lot of time. And then developed markets have pledged to deliver vaccines to the poorest countries. But again, it's going to take time. And honestly, it's not going to be enough.
To conclude, Céline, are you still optimistic about the fight against COVID-19 in the emerging world?
I think we should be optimistic just because we see that vaccination campaigns are picking up pace at home and there's been a lot of progress that has been made. We can't forget that. We should celebrate that progress. But we should remain prudent because a lot of uncertainty is still present. And we know that the only way to truly beat COVID-19 at home is to beat it everywhere.
Céline Boulenger, good to talk to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.